Right, according to everything that I'm using in terms of like senses and faculties and stuff, we are live right now. That's what I'm being told by my sources, my contacts.
Many people have said we are live right now. Many people.
I'm Aaron. This is Jason.
Hey, everybody. Nice to be part of the fun time gang. Yeah.
It is going to be a fun time, because guess what? Everyone who's watching this broadcast can get involved with this game. It's probably one of the most enjoyable things that I've seen in quite some time. It's called Quiplash. It's from You Don't Know Jack. Not only that, but now you can comment, and it'll show up on the sidebar.
Cool. We've got some really fantastic comments already.
There's been some good ones. We Was Kings. That's my favorite one so far.
That is pretty good.
So what's going to happen here, and I'll explain it as we go. I know Dr. Pussy Fun's Disease. That's a reference to Skyrim for Pimps. We are going to be playing this game with our patrons. We're going to play with about 8 people. But you, as the people watching this, can go to a website, jackbox.tv. And Adam's going to put all these things in the description eventually. But if you go to jackbox.tv and wait for a code... what are they refreshing, Adam? What are you saying? Yeah. Okay. Yeah. All the information you need is in the description of this video. Adam's also going to post it in the comments. And it's jackbox.tv. You can play the game, or you can actually be an active audience member and vote for whose answers you like the best via that website.
Yeah, do that. Be an audience member who votes.
Hey, everybody. This is a special guest tonight, Jason. He is not usually on our live broadcast. Hi, Jason. Welcome to the show.
Hey, Aaron. Aaron, right?
Yeah, that's me. I'm Aaron.
Yep.
Emery's editing Skyrim for Pimps, so he can't join us. And we're going to play this. We're going to start. We're just going to get started.
Cool. Let's do it.
All right. So I'm going to go to play game.
I'm going to go to play a game.
That's right. I got a heart.
I got a heart on, too.
Okay, Adam, I'm sending you the code. Give that to our patrons so they can join. Wait, Jason, don't.
What?
Back out.
What?
You're going to be the host.
I can't do it. I just made a mistake.
Hold on. I was actually supposed to do it first, so I'm going to back out.
Okay, you got to back out because I made a mistake.
I'm going to back out.
Sorry. First time... being on the show. I'm a big fan.
Yeah, what's up, Dadum?
Me?
Yeah, okay, so, don't join in yet, Jason.
I'm not gonna.
Just give it to our patrons right away, Adam, because they can't see it immediately. They can see it.
You tell me, Aaron, when I need to...
Well,
somebody took Trump. Will that be confusing? I didn't get in.
Hold on, guys. Just hold on a second. We'll start a game in a second. You just gotta give me a second. Okay, nobody enters the code yet until after I enter it. Here I go. Otherwise, you're not gonna be able to see anything that's happening in the game. Okay. Bam. I'm the host. Join Jason. Give that on Discord immediately, Adam. And if you see it and you're on this website, well, then you're playing, I guess.
Hey, it's good to see that me is in.
All right, guys. So if you want to be in the audience, feel free to join in at any point. We're starting the game. Here we go. This is going to be great. Morgan, can you do the play-by-play here?
Yes. This is a game, and we're going to play it. And what happens, see, is we come up with funny things, answers to questions. And then you guys vote on them, and we vote on them, and the person with the most votes wins. It'll make sense to you, unless you suffered a brain injury.
So now we're all going to put in our answers, and then you guys get to vote on them. Just keep watching. You'll get it. It's super simple. It's going to be really funny. We were playing this earlier and just about died from the answers people were giving. Oh, okay. This is a good one. Oh, yeah. All right. We're putting our answers in right now. So just drink a beer. And we're going to put our answers in, and then you'll get to see them. All right, I got my answers in. Bam, there you go.
Now, they said that I was a little loud over there.
Oh, well, you could back off a little bit of your mic if you
want. Oh, yes, I'll just do that. I'll back off. So weird being...
Oh, I'm sorry, Morgan. I didn't mean to interrupt you. Can you forgive that?
I forgive you.
Thank you, Morgan.
My child.
You're God, aren't you, Morgan?
Yes. One time I committed adultery, though.
Who the fuck are we waiting on?
You're waiting on that little blue fella down there. Hey, it's Dawn Sims. She's nice.
Funkelstein. All right, here we go. This is where you, the audience, get to vote if you're on Jackbox.tv.
Yeah.
A weird physical way to greet someone. Thumb in butthole or rubbing penis on their butt. Boy, that's a tough call, honestly. Morgan, which would you choose?
Well, I would probably suggest you don't touch their butt at all. You know.
Okay, what would it be a weird physical way you would greet someone then, Morgan?
Shoving your thumb up their ass is probably a bad one.
Okay, all right. Well, that was actually your answer, Morgan.
Yes, it was.
Yes. Well, we split the audience on that one, although I think the overall... Dreiskull got the overall audience.
You got a little bit more.
Yep.
It's just like anyone who runs into you or I, that's how you'll be greeted.
The real secret to living to age 100, skooma or the blood of the innocent? I think I know the answer to this one. What does Obama think about the secret to living to age 100?
I asked Clara Mycroft. She's a 102-year-old woman living in a nursing home in Atlanta, Georgia. And she said the secret to living past age 100 is every year she kills a baby and drinks its blood.
Okay, all right. Well, apparently skooma was the right answer. The first thing you would do after winning the lottery, eat a man's anus or shit bricks?
Okay.
Tallying votes, drinking beer.
Oh my goodness, I don't know. I don't know what to do.
Hey, we've got 30 people voting in the audience. If you want to vote, go to jackbox.tv and you can actually cast a vote.
One vote for eat a man's anus.
Oh, come on. Thank you, JWM. I appreciate that. Jesus Christ, I got annihilated. Why doesn't anyone want to eat a man's anus after they win the lottery?
The first thing I would do?
Well, the worst thing that could jump out of a bachelor party cake, me, Aaron, or the bride. Holy shit, I know
what
the answer is.
Is it the bride from Quentin Tarantino's films?
I think it's the bride from The Bride of Frankenstein.
Oh, yeah.
Kill Bill is what you're talking about.
Kill Bill is the thing that my brain cells can't come up with. Danzig rules!
Heron in a bride's dress, that's
Mother,
a good answer.
Butter, wanna put some on my bread?
I don't know who me is, but you only got two votes. I voted for you.
Yeah.
Funkelstein dominated.
Yeah. Funkelstein is...
We got funkled.
Yes, the bride from Kill Bill.
A terrible name for a 1930s gangster. Munchy or Pissy Nips?
Oh, fuck.
Take your pick. If you want to every so often put the code in the comments again, Adam, you could do that. So if new people...
Munchy Nips, good one.
Oh, yeah, you're right. Hey, you guys, I just noticed, because Adam mentioned it, you can see the code up in the upper right-hand corner of the screen.
Thanks, Funkelstein.
Oh, yeah! That's going to help me in the points area.
That was Aaron.
I was doing really badly.
No one uses nips as an adjective quite like Aaron Yanda.
I'm the best at words with nips. The name of a new game show that sounds terrible. Smell My Finger or Ball Busters? Is Ball Busters anything like Mythbusters? Where you look at various balls and try to figure out whether they could be done or not?
Well, what do you think about those balls, Jamie Heineman?
Oh, I think those balls are too big.
Yeah, Grayskull. Really.
Damn, Grayskull cleaning up right now. Really cleaning up. If God has a sense of humor, he welcomes people to heaven by saying, or, welcome to heaven, may I take your order? Oh man, I like both of those. I just really like the idea, or can you do God, so just like doing that? It's Morgan. Aren't you Morgan Freeman?
Welcome to heaven, may I take your order?
I'd like a mansion by the river. Are you okay, God? that was more on the side of Thalia, but Funkelstein got a couple votes. I can't wait for the point recap.
Yeah, so I can't keep track of how many points.
I'm sure I'm doing really bad. The worst thing you could stuff a bed mattress with.
I have some thoughts.
Live hookers or broken glass. I mean, live hookers wouldn't necessarily be bad, that bad, would they?
Well, I mean, you stuff the mattress. I thought it was you stuff the bed.
No, you're stuffing stuff a bed mattress. Whatever, you know, because a regular mattress, you wouldn't want to stuff that with anything. Whatever that means.
Oh, somebody wants to know if something happened to Christopher Walken. He hasn't heard any new Christopher Walken in a while.
Yeah, is Christopher okay?
He had a procedure.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
For what?
It's pretty crazy. He had to have his knees polished.
Because they had lost their shine over the years?
Yeah.
Over the years of, what, giving blowjobs? Yeah. I don't get it. Hey, I'm in third place. Being beat by Funkelstein. Who is Funkelstein? Okay, point values are doubled now, so your score is basically meaningless.
The point values are doubled.
I'm putting in my answers.
Okay.
Oh, man. This is a tough one. I'm trying to think, you guys. I have to shut up for a second. Oh, man. Oh, the puns. There's so many puns that I could make here.
Okay, I did it. I answered questions.
Yeah, I had problems with my kneecaps. They were all dull, dusty. So I had to go and get them shined. Everyone knows that monkeys
hate blank. Christopher, can you read that?
Everyone knows that monkeys hate hand jobs or democracy. One time when I was on the set of a film, I forget which one, I tried to give a hand job to a monkey. Turns out it was Christian Slater. He didn't like it.
Oh, wow.
I thought he was a monkey because his hair was all shaggy and he smelled bad. Jesus. He was eating a banana.
I tried to give a hand job to democracy once, Chris. And you know what happened?
What?
It didn't count.
No, of course not. Jason sucks. He lost the game.
Did you get no votes?
No votes.
I'm sorry.
No votes. No peace.
Can you read this one?
The Skittles flavor that just missed the cut. Pussy lips. Or vagina.
I can't believe everyone's answering these exactly the same.
Look, there's a big difference between pussy lips and vagina.
Flavored Skittles, yeah.
Yeah, I mean, one is the whole... the hole in the whole thing, really. And the other one is the outer labia. I don't know.
It looks like pussy lips. Won by a slight margin over a vagina. We are learning a lot here tonight.
Yeah.
On the Game Society Pinch
really
broadcast.
Really great.
Chris?
A sign that you're a bad teacher. First, that you don't eat pussy. Or teenage depression. These people's minds are in the gutters tonight. Maybe it's just one gutter.
By the way, if you want to get the code for the next game ahead of time and possibly have a better chance of getting in to play with us in the next match, go to our Patreon page. Come on, votes. I want all the vote. Oh, 50-50. I'll take it. I'll totally take it.
I voted for you, Aaron.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Seriously, you're not a good teacher if you won't do that.
No.
I don't care if you're...
What if you're a shop teacher, though?
Well,
yeah.
Then you won't eat anything.
A great brand name for extra, extra large condoms. King Schlong or the GSPs. Now, this is a great brand name out for an extra, extra large condom. I would call it the Morgan Freeman.
Just that? What would the logo look like?
This be me smiling. Me without a shirt on, smiling. I'm holding a giant penis, but you can't see it because the photo cuts off there.
Damn, King Schlong dominated.
Dominate, son.
That's Game Society Pimps Patreon. Patreon.com/Game Society Pimps. And if you get in at if you pay $10 a month, even just for 1 month, you can do it more, obviously, but 1 month, then you can try to. We'll give you this code ahead of time tonight, and you also will get a host of other rewards.
The worst excuse for showing up late to work: dick stuck in pie, or I thought I was fired.
We will not be doing anything highbrow tonight. Do not even think that that's an option. However, if you do a really good, highbrow answer, it could win. You might surprise yourself. Or just clever. Even puns will be acceptable tonight. I will forego the ban on puns. And if Jason resists my ban on puns, I will fire him.
Okay. So, I don't understand. Is there a ban on puns? Can puns get back in, or...
No, there's a ban on puns. They're not allowed into the Game Society Pimps country.
A bad name for an Italian restaurant.
Or Patio Gill's Pasta Bar.
Oh, man. Dude, that's a great name for an Italian restaurant. I would go there in a second.
Oh, my God. And I said Italian because that's how my mother says it. But I really know that it's Italian.
I actually voted for Patio Gill's, even though I think it's a really good name, but... I know my opinion's not normal, so...
Would that not be Emery's dream come true to have a pasta restaurant named after him?
Oh, God, yes. One that he didn't have to run or have anything to do with. Just go there and eat for free every day. Yeah, by the way, Emery's name was spelled wrong, but that was totally fine. It's impossible to spell.
Something squirrels probably do when no one is looking. Touch nuts or play with their nuts. Basically the same kind of... I don't know. I mean, I suppose it's a different thing.
It is different, because if you're playing with your own nuts, touching nuts could be someone else's nuts.
Yeah. Miss Uke is, that's right, yes. Beef O'Brady's is a real restaurant.
Come on. Give me all the votes. I knew that would be 50-50 because we answered the same. Yeah. Good job, Funkelstein. Touche, sort of.
I voted for Funkelstein because they put more effort into their answer.
Oh, son of a bitch. I think the audience voted for Funkelstein.
Yeah.
The biggest downside to living in hell. Time to vote.
You know, you got you said something about you said something, Aaron, about clever answers.
Yes.
And you know,
these are clever. Clever answers are easily acceptable. 72 votes on that one from the audience. That's impressive.
Nice.
And the audience took living with Trump. By a slim margin, just they're split just like the rest of the country on everything that happens in our country.
Yes.
Split down the fucking middle.
Do you want me to keep the bad people out, or do you want to give me the keys to the nation?
Oh, man, I dropped like a bitch.
I'm in fifth. Last place.
Oh, this is it, everybody. Everybody answers this one. You get three votes if you're a regular player, and you can vote three times for the same one, or you can split your points between the two different answers. It's up to you.
Okay.
Come up with the name of a country that doesn't exist. All right, I got my answer. I don't know if I'm going to win, but I'm pretty proud of myself right now. By the way, if you want a shout-out, we can do shout-outs tonight. Obviously, we're not playing Skyrim, so you can't choose, like, what we're doing for adventures. But if you want a shout-out, go to the description. There's a PayPal thing down there, and it explains it all. We'll do it. Come up with the name of a country that doesn't exist. Spain 2, United States of America, Sweaty Anus, the Morgan Freematorium, Trump Plantis, Anti-France, Emery Jahangistan, Shia LaBeoufistan. Shia LaBeoufistan. Oh my god.
Okay.
What am I going to do? Well, I'm definitely going to split my votes up.
Yeah. This is a lot of fun.
This is great. This is a good game.
Oh, awesome. Up to almost 80 votes.
Damn.
Koi is a lifelong subscriber.
Damn.
Sorry, Koi.
Lifetime subscriber, first-time commenter.
Yeah.
Trumplantis
gets a couple of
6%.
Votes there. That's not bad.
All right. Sweaty Anus.
Couple there.
Also 7%. Because of audience votes.
Oh, the audience, yeah.
Yep. Oh, the audience votes are down below. That's cool. Anti-France. 3 votes plus 7 audience, 9%.
Okay.
Interesting. Shia LaBeoufistan. 3 votes plus 11 audience, 13%.
That's okay. I'll take it.
Good job, Jason. You're winning right now.
No.
1 vote for Spain, too. Thank you for that. I should have won. That got more audience votes, though, so I actually got a good percentage. Thank you, audience. Thank you for understanding. United States of America.
That's a nice turn on that one. The Morgan Freematorium.
Oh, damn it. I think this is going to get... Ooh, damn. Tied for first. And finally, Emery, Jahangistan. Holy shit.
Yep.
That's taking the cake.
Yeah. Got to know the audience, right?
God damn it, Funkelstein.
Funkelstein plays to the audience really well.
Yeah, they sure do. They know all the references.
They? Is it like twins? Yeah, I'm not in last place anymore.
Nope. Funkelstein dominated, though. Good job, Funkelstein. All right, we're going to start another match. But we're going to go and try to... We're going to get new players for this one.
New players?
But feel free to join right back in if you can. It's kind of a first-come, first-serve situation, so... All right. We'll take a few seconds. Uh-huh. Yeah. I got it, Adam. This one's not going forward, you guys, so feel free to join, but I'm going to restart. All right, so I have a little thing here from Joshua Nelson. He donated. He wants Adam Sandler to pitch his new movie to Donald Trump.
Hey, Don, what's his name?
Joshua Nelson.
Hey, Donald, I'm here to talk about my new movie. It's from Joshua Nelson.
Oh, that sounds so good. I bet it's going to be a wonderful film. Tell me about it. Who's in it? What's going on?
Well, I play a giant shithead, and I go around and I go, you know what to do.
I love it. How much money do you need? Do you need $1 billion? I want to see this movie on a big screen.
Whoa!
You're the funniest man on earth, in the earth. You're the funniest. I would present you with a crown, a king, comedy king. You're the king of the comedy.
There you go.
That was wonderful.
Yes, he has had really bad brain surgery. Sorry.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right, so... Adam, I'm going to try to type this in two places.
Are you talking to me?
So we get ready, Adam.
Are you talking to me?
No, Adam. I mean, oh, God damn it. There's two Adams. Son of a bitch.
I like Adam. Here's my friend.
Okay, let me do this first.
Adam, do you have any of that crack? I really like your crack.
There it is, Adam. Quick, put that on Patreon. I mean, on the thing, you know what I mean.
I did not make it in. No, I did. There I am.
You're there? Okay.
Yep,
Jason's in. We tried to get that in Patreon as quick as we could, but it's very difficult.
So. Very difficult.
Everybody's in. Here we go.
I'm glad to see King Candy and Professor Plum are in.
Now, there's some Blame Society references. Yeah. Even though they're Candyland. Really?
Yes. Of course I can do Morgan Freeman. That's my favorite. You see. And there's Sean Henry. Hello, sir.
All right, if you want to be in the audience, there's your code. Go ahead. Cast your vote.
Have some good times.
Excuse me. All right, we're answering questions now, so talk amongst yourselves. Oh, damn it. I didn't know how to fill that one in. Shoot. All right, well, I fucked that one up. There was one with two answers, and I totally screwed it. I screwed the hooch. I hear Adam Sandler isn't very wee these days. I don't know what that means. All right, wait in two suckas. An orange shake of some sort.
It's Master Shake. That's wonderful.
Damn, we've got a big audience this time. This is going to be good. Lots of votes. Lots of votes. Here we go.
Okay, it's time for some quiplashing.
All right, and we are off. A thought that keeps... Oh, sorry.
No, you do it. I like it.
A thought that keeps Santa Claus awake at night. Mrs. Claus's lumpy plum pudding... I think we all know what he means. Or all the murders.
Okay. The video is delayed because that's what YouTube does. They don't let you do a true live broadcast. They just delay it a little bit.
Can I do Bob Ross? Oh, I think we're going to do a little few happy trees there. And some happy little trees there.
Bob Ross keeps Santa Claus awake at night.
Yeah.
Ooh, we split that one down the middle. Oh, yeah, I got a couple more audience points.
Pretty good, Aaron.
Sweet!
I don't think Santa would be kept awake by all the murders.
Oh, just a specific one?
Specific murders, yeah. Mm-hmm. Come up with a name for a beer made especially for monkeys. Gore-ala? or Harambe Light?
Those are both genius.
Oh, wow.
This is not fair.
Invoking the name of Harambe.
All right, well, unfortunately for me, I had to go with the non-pun one, even though I am allowing puns.
You did suggest puns.
I did, but that doesn't mean I'm going to choose them. I'm just saying that they're allowed in the country just for tonight.
Yes. I got a couple there. That's not bad.
Sorry,
Thank
Jason.
You, audience. No,
sorry,
it's
Jason.
Commendable.
I feel really bad now. I did suggest puns, and I should have.
Yeah.
I betrayed you. Yeah. Can we still be friends?
Harambeer.
Harambeer.
I saw that
good.
In the comments there. An unusual special skill to include on your resume.
Voluminous.
Voluminous seepage. Or I can clench my anus extremely tight. So basically, opposing skills.
Yeah. Like either.
Oh,
you're either like willing to take it in or can't control it coming out.
Right, right. Like it's just. It's like a.
You can control it coming in, but you can't control it coming out.
I would say, well, an unusual. I'm really trying to digest this.
JWM cleans up.
Well,
wait,
the audience
didn't, though.
Votes,
the audience.
The audience votes was they were into
wow.
the.
Wow! Damn, the audience vote really made a difference that time.
They really enjoyed the tightly clenched anus.
They do enjoy tightly clenched anuses, ain't I?
Go ahead, you can read it.
Like chicken fingers or chicken poppers, the new appetizer name for your fun theme restaurant, chicken fried nipples or chicken balls, hashtag let's hang out.
Okay.
Oh my god.
Someone asked me in the comments if I could do Bane, and yes, I can do Bane.
Bane doing the...
chicken balls, let's hang out. Batman, my nuts itch. Nah, maybe I can't do it.
That's
not
pretty
right
good.
Now.
I like the mechanical effect. That was good.
Yeah, that was my hand.
Adam liked it too.
That. Good.
Fried nipples, won what? Fried nipples won a massive audience support.
Yeah, that was a good one for them.
Holy shit, Jason.
A reason to get into a fist fight with a koala bear. He fucked your wife, or it stole your lady. See, one is the rated R, and the other one is the rated G. Oh, boy. But you know what? If he fucks your wife, it's just one time. But if he stole your lady...
It's forever.
It's forever.
Oh, shit, I didn't think about that. I want to change
my
vote.
Like, and stole the lady is like... Took her against her will. Fucked her wife? Maybe she was into it, you know?
Oh, yeah. Yep.
Yeah.
I don't know. I think the word fuck kind of helped.
Yeah, people are into fuck.
People are into fuck.
People are really into
they
fuck.
They love fuck.
They are into it.
You should never blank and blank at the same time.
Shit. Just that. You should never shit and shit at the same time. Or you should never cook and come at the same time.
It's a tough call.
Yeah, it's a difficult...
Yep. It's going to be really hard to not choose anything but cook and cum.
Yeah. People are demanding this. This is, This is what we've come to deserve.
Right? I accidentally didn't type two answers. I'm an asshole.
Yeah, and you lost because of it.
Thank you for the audience votes. Sympathy.
They didn't know it was you, or they would have given more votes.
No, they wouldn't.
Yeah, they would.
They love to see me suffer.
Next up, the name of your new plumbing company.
Name of your new plumbing company. Hitler the Plumber.
Mariah.
Oh man. Well, I don't encourage.
It's Hitler, comma the plumber.
Yeah, the punctuation really makes it. I think. But Mariah is pretty good, too.
This sink's backed up. Can you call Mariah again?
All right, let's see where... Oh, damn. Hitler always wins, except for World War II.
Or if you invoke his name in an argument. That's typically not...
I'm here to fix your pipes. I'm here about the leak.
What dogs think when they see people naked?
Fuck yeah!
Or,
Why do you only have hair down there?
Right, why do you only have hair down there? That's the tense I think we're looking for here.
I wonder what, like, a fish thinks of when it sees a person naked. Like, if you just go skinny dipping?
It starts baiting. Get it?
Yeah. King Candy. Nice one. Well, the audience
fairly
votes were...
well split. The audience liked the dog asking why you only have hair down there. A lot of dog owners out there that their dogs wondering that all the time. They're in touch. They're dog whisperers. Oh, shit. Here we go. I am not winning. Oh, thank God for JWM. Yeah. Who's winning?
I'm not. I missed who it was. I'm in second place. All point values are doubled.
Here we go. We're answering. Talk amongst yourselves.
Yes. All right. We'll have to see how everyone does. Can I do Louis Anderson? Yes, I can. I love Louis Anderson in Baskets. Let me see if I can think of something to say.
Oh, come on, Chip. You know, I love Costco.
Yeah, that's... yeah. Jackson, you are mean. Don't call me a dumb. Yes, my character looks like a booger. Carlos, those words hurt.
All right. Damn, am I the last one? I feel so...
No, it's okay, Jackson.
Well,
You're not
fine. The last one.
You're fine. I am a great...
A strange side effect to hear... Who can read these ones? Do you got somebody?
A strange side effect to hear doing a drug commercial, partial rectal prolapse, or sporadic racism.
Okay, that was a pretty weak Schwarzenegger, as far as they go. My Macho Man is good, but because I'm on a decent mic, I don't want to blow your ears off. Sporadical racism would be a weird one, yeah. I voted for partial rectal prolapse, but I think that's just because it sounded medical.
King Candy cleaned up on that one. Something that's made worse by adding cheese. Fried rice or your body? Arnold, which one would you pick?
You know, sometimes sometimes when you put cheese inside your body, it makes your poop get hard, and then you cannot poop. And then you're on the toilet, and you're like, yeah, get out, I cannot poop. Maria, oh, I forgot.
Get to the pooper.
Oh, that's a shame.
Yeah.
That's
oh
a shame,
God.
Because literally Chinese food with cheddar cheese on it is the worst thing ever.
That was you versus me.
That was me versus me with a real answer versus you with, like, your typical
shit. Oh, that was
shit.
Clever. I didn't put any swear words or anything naughty in there.
No, and I... whatever.
Super clever.
A trick you'd like to see a poodle do. Escaping a straitjacket underwater, walk a human, and make it shit on the lawn. my laughter, I don't want my laughter, my giggling to influence votes, so just vote your conscience.
Hey man, it's a tough world. Not everybody gets a goddamn trophy, you know?
No, that's true.
Look at you last turn.
Oh, it's the worst. One vote. Like 18% of the audience.
I got all the trophies.
Yeah.
Holy shit.
Oh,
I'm
JWM.
I'm just incredible cleaned up. Yep. Like a boss. Sorry, JWM.
Like a boss.
quiplashed.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, you get like bonus points.
I had a heart attack when I was driving and I died.
There you go. There's your Macho Man.
Do it.
What an alarm clock would say that would wake you right up.
What an alarm clock could say that would wake you right up.
I'm pregnant or Trump's been impeached.
Oh boy, topical versus
I'd get
forever.
Woke. I'd get woke right the fuck up.
Yeah, remember now, if you get all the player votes, I think it doubles your score.
Oh, wow. That's pretty amazing.
It's pretty cool.
That's really great. Pretty good, decent split there.
Yep, that's about as splitty as giddy.
I've got two small children, so I'm pregnant does not, it doesn't compute anymore.
Safety tip, don't eat a half hour before you. Swallow cyanide pills.
Or
before you perform an autopsy on your father. Oh my god. Hey, you and me should switch off. I read one, you read the next.
That's what I thought we were doing.
Is that what we're doing? I don't even know.
I need another beer, by the way.
I will get another
beer.
Adam, I do PMs in between matches. Yeah. Jason cleans up.
I did all right.
Audience vote not quite as well decided, but good answer for yeah. Jason. Should give him a chance of getting third or maybe even fourth place.
A good improvement to make to Mount Rushmore. Add Stone Cox or Donald Trump.
Hmm. This will tell us the nature of our audience.
Yes. A good improvement to make to Mount Rushmore.
If it's a true America.
Look, if I'm going to go on Mount Rushmore, you got to give me a giant stone cock. Giant stone cock. Bigger than Roosevelt's. Way bigger than Roosevelt's.
I bet Teddy Roosevelt was hung like a moose.
Oh, yeah, I bet. I bet he actually had a moose cock.
He may have.
He probably had that surgically implanted. The first cock transplant with Teddy Roosevelt when he got an actual moose.
Roosevelt was a real cocksmith, boy, let me tell you.
A good post-music career for Justin Bieber. President of hell or airline stewardess. Oh, man. Too good.
He'll clean your GameCube for money is the only comment I needed to see. I just had this vision of Trump sitting in the Oval Office, cleaning a GameCube with Q-tips, watching an Adam Corlick video.
Yes.
This guy is walking me through how to clean my Dreamcast.
Like, at 4 a.m., after he's done tweeting, he starts cleaning a Dreamcast and watching Adam Corlick videos.
This guy really knows how to clean these old consoles.
Okay, fine. What do you want to talk about then? Why did Black Sabbath have white members? And also no answer.
Okay, we don't have to vote on that one.
No. That's actually kind of a shame because I don't think you get the extra points, do you?
I don't know. Probably not. That's a bummer. That is a real bummer.
Well, Professor Plum can't be in first anymore.
Oh, I'm in second. I've shot right the fuck up.
You're in what? Second?
I'm in second. You're in fourth.
Second?
That's right, second.
The last lash. All point values have tripled. Everyone gets the same prompt. Here we go.
If you are in second place, hopefully you will go first.
Something you promise to yell if you win this game.
Oh, okay. Oh man, all I can think of is really awful things. Oh god, why did it spell correct to that?
You can't have spell correct on and play this game. Maybe that's the tip here.
I gotta tell you what it actually, like, typed in for me. Or maybe I accidentally typed it in, I don't know.
I don't know. Here are the choices, folks. I have a big dick, I had Jacupan that was mine. There's a bomb planted in the White House. Not in my butt, please. I touched baby cookie.
Adrian!
Umber Hulk smudge nuts. And run, the whores are coming.
All right, submitted. All right.
So the audience, the players get 3 votes. Audience members get only 1 vote.
Now we're up to 100, almost up to 100. 101 audience votes, 103 audience votes, 104. 104. Holy balls.
These numbers, they're crazy, they're out of control. They're out of control.
A third of our audience who's watching the live version are actually playing along with us right now.
Aaron was the only one who voted for the worst answer, which was mine.
Oh, dude, that was great. I loved that answer.
Umber
Come
Hulk.
On.
Yeah.
Guys.
D&D.
Brilliant.
Oh, well.
Shit.
I have a big dick. Come on. I thought that
one. I think it's
one.
An... Is it Umber? It is Umber, you're right.
Umber Hulk, yeah.
Yeah. All right, not a whole lot of percentages so far.
No.
Not a whole lot of point munching.
Couple there.
Okay, all right. That would probably bring the feds down.
There's got to be one that's just like the main.
Does there, though?
I don't
There
know.
Was last time.
I really don't know.
Adrian!
Can you just do that anyway?
No? Adrian!
Yeah,
yeah.
He did it. It didn't
matter. Adrian.
Win,
so. Hey, I'm Randy Newman.
Okay, I had Jackie Pan. That was mine. Has a lot of points. So far, it's the leader. Oh, wait a minute. Run, the whores are coming. Is that 15%? I might have to shout this, unless Not In My Butt Please wins. Not In My Butt Please. Holy
wow.
Shit, Not In My Butt Please dominated. All right, well, King Candy, you have to shout that. I don't know where you are or what you're doing, but you have to shout that.
I am in the hospital waiting room.
I'll shout it for you. Not In My Butt Please! Jason, do you want to shout it too?
Not In My Butt Please!
That's good.
I'm Morgan Freeman. Not In My Morgan Freeman butt.
I got second place that time.
Look at that. Look at the top answer of the game.
Hitler the plumber. Good job, Jason. Jason throwing out the only Hitler answer we've had so far.
I'm here to fix your pipes. I understand there's a leak in the tub.
Okay, so I'm going to get Jason a beer. Meanwhile, he's going to do what Alden Fisher suggests. Alden donated. He says, I told my job I had to leave the work meeting early because I had another meeting to get to.
Yes.
This counts as a meeting, right? Can Jason do John Madden talking about his Super Bowl party recipes? Thanks, love you guys. All right, I'll go get
you
a beer.
You know, one of the things I like to make is, I call them pigs in a blanket. I go to the store and I go down the back of the store where they keep all the Pillsbury dough rolls. And I get some of the tubes and I stick them down my pants. And then I walk out of the store like I forgot my wallet and I don't have to pay for them. But, you know, if it's too hot out and my nuts are really warm, then what happens is those canisters of dough, and they heat up. And then boom, boom, boom. Next thing you know, you got crescent rolls falling out of your pant leg. And then when you get home, you got all this pubic hair inside your pigs in a blanket. And I get the little weenie rolls. I get the little smokies. The little smokies, cocktail weenies, little sausages. I get those. I steal those from enough different store so that I got room in my pants for the crescent rolls later. And I like to put them down in the oven.
And then
Paul Simon comes over and sings a song about being white. Boom.
So, in that last...
What now? What happened?
In that last question that we did, what was the question?
What?
Something you'll shout.
Oh, yeah.
And I said, help.
Shout if you win.
Or I said, like, run, the whores are
run
coming.
Run, the whores.
My phone accidentally typed in, run, the whites are coming.
Oh.
Which, you know, nice. Is a commentary on...
Commentary on modern...
Everything. Modern and past.
Yeah.
Everybody.
Yep.
You know, sometimes I get stuck in a loop, and next thing you know, I gotta bonk me in the head, because I play a lot of football, and then that brain is traumatic, long-term side effects, and then there you go. But Aaron Rodgers is a really great quarterback, and he's going to throw down the field, Jordy Nelson, and then he'll catch it. You know, the Falcons have a great team. They have number one offense, and then the other team is the cheating Patriots. I call them the cheating Patriots, and they're pretty bad. And a lot of people say they're the worst team in football. I don't know what they're doing. The worst ratings. They're the failing New England Patriots.
Is that what their team is called now?
Fake football.
The failing New England
Patriots.
Yeah, they're
fake football. Fake football, the failing New England Patriots.
Well, John, I guess we know who you're rooting for.
Yeah, I have Falcons, I guess. I don't know. Who's in it? Because I don't watch it football anymore. Because I only watch pro wrestling.
All right, so I'm going to start a new one here and see if we can get that code out to our patrons a little quicker. It might not really work, but Adam, if you're ready to type something, and you tell me you're ready, I will type this in first, and then I will type myself in and see if it works. Okay. Here we go. There you go. Okay, don't type it in, Jason, because then you'll be the host, and we don't want that.
Well, I typed it, but I didn't enter it.
Okay, enter it.
I did not make it in.
Okay, sorry, that didn't work, so we're going to have to go back. And I'm going to try it again.
Hold on.
There you go, Adam. You're going to have to do that fast.
Hold on, I'm typing it still. Ah.
That's alright, Jason can be the host. Okay. Oh damn, Shitty Teeth is on board.
Shitty Teeth!
Dooble. Alright, so I think we're going to do this. You're going to be the host, I'm not sure if that's going to matter.
Okay, everybody's in, we're good to go.
We'll see what happens.
We've got a great audience. Everyone is here to see a wonderful, family-friendly live broadcast.
Fuck yeah. We love families. That's why we like to fuck them in the ass.
I like to practice making babies.
That sounds like a song.
Yeah?
Is that a
Randy Newman song?
Randy Newman song?
I like to practice making babies.
All right, we're putting in answers. Here we go. Yeah, so we're doing shout-outs. If you guys want shout-outs, check the description. Jason will do impressions, whatever you like.
You know, sometimes when you get the ants in your pants, you need to dance.
Maybe like one, yeah. Adam. Okay, I gotta put answers in, man. I gotta focus here.
You know, while Aaron's putting his answers in, I'm going to remind everyone that all kinds of fun stuff happens in the after party. If you're you think you got to be a special member, or you got to, you know, fax a picture of your left nut or something to Aaron. I don't know how that works. He's busy looking at his phone, so he didn't hear me.
Well, I just put in one of the most disturbing answers I put in so far. It's great.
A good sign that your house is haunted. Out of mayo, or the mailbox is making porn noises. Oh, God, they're both fantastic.
20.
Oh, man. Oh, Jesus. That is
for one
good
person, Adam.
You know, there's a part of society that cannot tolerate mayonnaise. I am not part of that portion of society.
Damn, I got fucked.
Dude, I
so
voted
sorry
for you. I voted for you.
Thank you, Jason.
Yeah.
You get me. You understand
when
me.
When I'm out of mayonnaise, the house is haunted. Yeah.
Damn.
We gotta read that.
One thing never to do on a first date, pump and dump, or bring a banjo.
Ha ha ha. Hey, are you a fan of Mumford & Sons? Because I sure am.
I know their whole library. Want me to sit down here on your stoop?
Hold on. Let me get some gasoline and a match.
Fly. Ah! All right, it looks like Pump and Dump Jason.
Yay.
Took that one.
That was my nickname in high school, Pump and Dump Jason.
Pump and Dump Jason.
Yeah, but not for the reasons you think. And next, using only two words, a new state motto for Texas. Hang 'em or humongous.
I think their motto should be hang 'em and humongous.
Oh boy, yeah.
Have you seen the humongous meme?
No.
Oh man, you gotta see that. It's funny.
I have a filter on my computer that takes off all memes.
That's too bad, because it's really, well, it's just a video, and it's just two of, like, the worst types of people in America, basically. Like, the guy who thinks humongous is funny, and an SJW social justice warrior that thinks that humongous is offensive. And it's just like the worst two aspects of our culture.
That's hilarious.
It's amazing. Another name for a
rectal thermometer. You want to read that?
Another name for a rectal thermometer. Pooper Worth Tester. Or a temperature dildo.
With a colon behind it.
Yes. That's because there was more to come. Yes. I don't know.
Or it's just a colon. It's inside the colon. It's on the... You get it? Colon? Anus? I don't know. I don't know.
I kind of get it.
I don't know.
No, nobody gets you, right, Jason?
Nobody understands.
Holy domination. You're going to get double the points for that one.
Sorry, Dooble.
That's a lot of points.
I wonder.
Snail man.
Yeah, I wonder if it was because he left the M out of warmth and people got confused.
Next in line. Yeah, that might be it.
The worst shape for an animal cracker. Engorged puss or amoeba? I suppose it would be engorged puss, wouldn't it?
Oh, yeah. Mm-hmm.
Some of those animal crackers, they kind of look like engorged pusses or amoebas. You can't tell. Like, what is this, a giraffe? I'm trying to teach my children about animals.
Is this a giraffe or an engorged puss?
I'm sorry, son. I think this might be an engorged puss. Ask your mother what that is. Because I don't know.
Oh yeah, I cleaned it. I cummed in her bun.
In her bun.
I cummed her bun.
Now I'm hungry for buns. Thanks, Aaron.
You're welcome.
A weird thing to find in your grandparents' bedside table. A big-ass toothbrush or shitty teeth.
Oh. Oh, man. Those are both good answers. I wanted to split my vote.
How bizarre that they are so tightly related.
They are tightly related.
Mm-hmm. I remember reading Marilyn Manson's biography, and he talked about his grandfather's, like, he had these old trains down in his basement, and a dildo covered in Vaseline, and it was weird. Anyway. I was like, oh, that's odd. That's how you become Marilyn Manson. Okay, I get it.
You know, what's really funny is I was helping my boss clean out his old house once at this old job I had. A terrible sportscaster catchphrase for when somebody dunks a basketball. I am a cuck. Or Ducky McDucky Dunk. Those are both good. I was helping him clean out his old house that he was moving from.
Yeah.
And, I found this box in his closet and it had a giant dildo in it.
Oh my god.
And he was like really fucking embarrassed. And I was like, and he was like, I got that because a guy like really screwed me over. And you know, like he didn't pay me when I did a job for him. Yeah. And like, I was gonna mail it to him. Sorry, Jason.
Holy
damn,
shit.
You got cucked.
I thought that was really funny when I typed that.
You got a good audience percentage though.
Yeah.
It wasn't terrible.
Yeah, just.
But he was going to send it to a guy out of rage to, like, get him. And
he was going
to
rage dildo a guy?
Never sent it, so...
The most bitching thing you can airbrush on your van. A fucking bald eagle, bitch. Or my wife.
Uh,
Man, I'm tore up about that. I'm a cuck not getting any votes.
Hey, I had one early, too, that got nothing.
That was really funny when I thought of it. Because I was thinking of, like, what's the guy who does the basketball stuff? Dick Vitale. I was thinking of Dick Vitale. Dickie V. I was thinking of him saying, I'm a cuck! Just the guy dunks, you know? I'm a cuck!
I see that there is some shot money coming our way.
I'm up for a shot.
Shotsy Nazi. Shotsy Nazi.
Yep.
There will be an after party after this. Oh, here comes the points.
I was in first place for a second, and then last place forever.
Oh, Jason. Oh, that's
rough. It's okay. It's all right. I'm still alive.
You are a cuck now.
I'm a cuck. Wait a minute. What? How did I get cucked? Did the Russian man have my wife? I don't know.
I think Obama took your wife.
Yeah, maybe.
She hasn't been seen for like 12 days. Maybe she's on vacation with the Obamas. All right, we're filling out stuff here.
Yeah,
you talk amongst yourselves.
Yeah, hang out. Just do your thing. I'm feeling really good about my answers, guys. I'm not going to lie to you. I'm feeling really positive. I got a piece that's gonna be in a video on Cosmo the magazine Cosmo. I got a thing that I'm gonna record
Cosmo,
for them.
Cosmo, really?
Yeah, a little piece.
Do they have buns? Because otherwise I don't want any.
A catchy name for a sperm bank. Dickpository or Little White Babies.
Little White Baby sounds like a pain reliever.
Before my wife and I had our oldest child, our first child, we went to a fertility clinic for their like open house to go over, here's what we would do if you decide to come here. And my main concern was the type of pornography they had available. I just didn't care. I was like, really? Playboy? Are you sure? This is all airbrush shit. Like, what?
There's only magazines? They don't have, like, videos?
They might have.
Must have videos now or something. A bad name for a pet goldfish. I'm a cuckfish. That must be Jason's answer. I'm just kidding. Or Scorpy the floating mini dolphin.
Oh, man.
I'm trying to imagine that. Like, come here, I'm a cuckfish. Or, well, it's not a dog, but...
Yeah.
I gotta go with that one.
I'm not gonna lie, I was hoping to pick up some sympathy votes on this one.
I gotta go feed Scorpy the floating mini dolphin.
That is a tough answer to be up against, though.
Yeah, it is. It really is.
And you didn't do me any favors, Aaron.
Sorry.
Fuck you.
You got bada boomed.
I got cucked again with the cuck answer. Yeah.
Shouldn't really work towards sympathy votes. That's not really... I mean, you might eventually start winning every answer.
I'd have to put like 7 cuck answers in to get it to work.
Yeah, then you might win eventually.
The best way to defeat terrorism is mindless violence or to build a wall and make Mexico pay for it. So anyway, as it turns out, then we had a baby without needing anything, which was fortunate, because if you've ever made a baby with help of science, you know it's fucking expensive.
Wait, you're saying you didn't need to go to the bait clinic?
No, we didn't have to go. I still masturbated, but I didn't need to save it.
But it was just like the normal unnecessary. Yeah. It wasn't like...
Right. Just, like, I didn't have to leave the house to do it.
Right.
I didn't have to go somewhere.
You have to go to a clinic. That would be awkward. The name of the reindeer Santa didn't pick to pull his sleigh. Bluebells or Emery the Red-Nosed Jehunger.
Oh, man.
Wow. Okay, those are both good.
They're very good.
I forgot who won on the last one. Was it split? It was pretty split, wasn't it?
Yeah. The build the wall one.
Oh yeah.
Good night, Neon Unicorn. It's been nice hanging out with you. Emery.
All right, Shitty Teeth takes it with Emery.
Pretty even split on the live audience, though.
A lot of Emery-related answers.
Somebody wants to know what's happening with the stream.
I don't know. We're doing a game.
Little known fact, an unaired episode of the Brady Bunch had the family dealing with hunting accidents or lupus and racism.
Oh my god, that's good.
Yeah, Emery the reindeer would do nothing but sleep. He wouldn't pull the sleigh unless Santa gave him pasta. Good one, Chris.
I think if Santa would just have to whip him constantly. Oh, you fucker! You totally destroyed me.
I did.
Son of a bitch.
Yeah. Yep, I did that.
Dude, I deserved that, I guess. Yep. After all that cuck shit?
Yeah. Lupus, you know, lupus is a real bitch. I know people with lupus. It's not... So that's why I put racism in there, too.
Are you reading this one?
No, you read it.
A name for a really cheap hotel. Aaron's Jokes. B&B.
Or Homotel.
Or Homotel.
Oh.
Hmm.
Hey, Ghastly.
Guess I know which one I'm not picking. My jokes are not cheap. They come at a high cost.
A high cost to you.
Thank you.
Yeah. Sorry, Bada Boom.
Oh, the audience fucking liked Bada Boom.
Yeah, they did. They liked it.
Too bad he got dominated.
Yeah. Jackal. Nicely done. The 6,077th layer of hell is reserved for sea turtles, mostly, or the people who still use Hela.
Those are both good.
They're both very good.
But during our after party, we're probably going to play this again. Because then just patrons will play with us. So if you want to be a patron who plays with us, become a patron.
Pretty
the
even.
After party is available for who, Adam? At what level? $5 a month will get you access to all the after parties we do every month. That's all it takes. $5. And then tonight you'll be able to play this during the after party with us. A new name for kumquats. Jizzgourd. Or long orange things.
Have you had both your answers pop up, Aaron?
Yes.
Okay, because I was thinking Jizzgourd sounds like an Aaron Yanda answer.
That is not an Aaron Yanda answer. If it was, it would be a cheap one, apparently.
Yeah, you usually don't use jizz as an adjective.
I will now, though. All my answers will now have jizz in them, so if you want to vote for me, vote for jizz.
Yeah. Shitty teeth.
Shitty cheese. Shitty cheese. Shitty teeth cleans up. Winner bonus. Oh, I can't wait for the scoring recap.
This is... I'm riveted to it.
I am, too. I'm riveted to it. Okay, this is how it was. Jason was in last place. I was in fourth. I am now almost in last place.
I'm in second place.
Damn.
I went from last to second, Aaron.
You can
suck it.
Do this, Jason.
I can do it.
You can do it.
I can do it.
Oh, can do it.
You're my friend, Aaron.
I love you, Dathan.
Oh. Sorry, everyone.
Welcome to the James Society Peach Channel. An invention by Thomas Edison that never caught on. Oh, man. Oh, what are those called? Fuck it. Welcome. Oh god, I almost died saying welcome. Welcome, Jaden.
Jaden Smith? Will Smith's son? Oh, that's amazing.
The electric spanker?
Mmm.
That's what somebody suggested?
Yeah.
Why the name change? I mean, we still call ourselves the Game Society Pence. It's just like sort of like, what do you call it? Just on the surface, we're called Game Society.
All right. An invention by Thomas Edison that never caught on. Animal butthole mold. Thomas Edison electric sex dolls. Electric bathtubs. Jizz lamp. Electric bathtub. Fleshlight. The spiralic cock. A light switch that led to nothing. I like that electric bathtub and electric bathtubs were two different answers.
Yeah, that's crazy. Two of you people, two of you crazy, suicidal people had the same answer.
Yeah. I gave all three of my votes to one person.
Electrifying cock ring, yep. Uh-huh. Anything electric. The electric chair for Tesla.
The band? Ah, I'm all in favor.
JWM gets 7%. Good job, JW. Electric bathtubs? 9%.
Okay, 7%, 9%. Yeah, that's close. I can see that.
The spiralic cock.
Like a pig's penis. Is because
oh, that's what that is. See, I'm too stupid to know that.
Animal butthole mold.
Reference to Angry Hunter.
Okay.
Thank you, shitty teeth. Light switch that led to nothing. Damn, 12%. Damn, Dooble. Damn, Jason.
Yep. I did okay with that one.
Oh. Jason's currently in the lead. Will he be able to maintain his lead direction?
No, I was in second place.
Oh, what?
I was in second place overall.
I don't know. Yeah, but will you be able to maintain it?
I gave that all three of my votes.
Oh, hell yeah!
Because Aaron said he was going to use jizz in all of his titles, and he did.
And then I did. That's it. Let's take a look at the I'm the jizz scores. Master. It's not going to help me, pretty sure. Nope. Not even close. Damn, shitty teeth. Good job. That was awesome.
I just imagine Thomas Edison, like, hunkering over a lamp and just feverishly masturbating to try to make a jizz lamp.
Thomas Edison owned raves.
Yeah. He's like, no, because then Nikola Tesla would come in and he'd be like, what's all this shit fucking DC current shit? And then Edison would shake his fist and then Westinghouse would come in and, like, fucking cold cock Tesla and take his wallet and shit. It's bad scene back in the day. And then when Henry Ford died, everything went downhill.
All right, I'm to take shots.
Okay, I don't know what I'm supposed to do, but I'll do whatever I need to because I'm a team player.
You didn't get any shots, but do you want one?
No, thank you.
Rum
chata? No, it's okay. If I didn't get one, I don't want one. If no one made it happen, then I don't need one.
Wait, this is supposed to be cold.
Rum chata?
It wasn't.
Just don't be a fucking wimp and just drink it.
But it
not
was in the refrigerator,
cold.
And then I didn't put it back in the fridge. Do you think it'll be like poisoned?
Look, all the shit that you've drank over the last 7 seasons of Beer and Board Games, I think fucking warm rum chata is the least of your worries.
It has cream in it.
Is it supposed to be? Does it say on it, must be refrigerated?
Government warning.
Government warning.
No refrigeration.
Government warning. Do not drink this shit. It says drink vodka.
No refrigeration necessary, so...
Trump brand vodka. So good.
I guess it doesn't have to be because it has alcohol. All right, so...
Oh, I missed somebody. Somebody said something about Jason on there and I missed it.
I'm sorry. I'm sorry that you missed that.
It's okay.
What'd you say, Adam? Go ahead.
What now?
Alden actually sent money for you to have a shot as well.
Oh, my goodness. Do I have to drink that? Rum chata?
No, you can go get something else out of the cupboard if you wish.
Well, no, if I have to get up, I don't want to.
Jim Beam or something?
No,
but
that's fine.
I can't go get it for you because I'm doing a show.
Yeah. That's fine. I will drink this.
All right, here we go, everybody. Thank you to Alden. Thank you to Blake Miller.
Cheers.
Yeah, this is going to get lively. This is going to get lively. And now I have to have another one because Blake actually got me two. Jesus.
That's good.
It's good. It tastes like rice pudding.
It tastes a lot like Christmas time.
This will cure my cold, I'm pretty sure. Temperature right. Dildo, that was a classic. Okay, so now we're going to start another one. Here we go.
I got to do this.
Oh, Blake Miller also had a message.
This? New players?
Yeah, new players. But, oh, don't do it yet. Okay, it's too late. Just, we'll let this one go. It's fine. Don't. Nobody needs to join this
yeah,
one.
Yeah, this
restart.
Is just, I messed up.
You can join up if you want to, just to be fun.
I made a very grave error. Made a big mistake. I'm sorry, everyone.
Blake Miller says, here's two shots for urine. Looking forward to a very offensive after party. Well, you're going to get it now because you got me two shots. Hope to see you as drunk as you get in Disneyland Adventures. Oh, man. No, no. I will not do that. That is a sheer torture situation where I drink as much as possible so I don't remember any of it later. So, oh my god, someone is named Emery Sucks. That's such a good name.
And the password to get into the room is Q-tit. That's awesome. I'm really sorry I messed up, though.
It doesn't matter. It's totally fine. I don't have a problem with it.
Sometimes I use Q-tips on my tits.
Q-tits. That's why they're called Q-tits. All right, here we go with another round. I'm going to... Emery. Jesus. Sorry, Adam. Are you ready, Adam, to get this information? Okay, but get ready to type it into our Discord. Okay, hold on.
The technology that goes into this...
Did you beat me?
Yes.
Damn it. It's okay. It was fine having you as the host. I don't give a shit.
Double nut. Hey, Gray Skull's back in. That's good. CB.
All right. Our team is here. Let's do it. Press the start.
Everybody's in.
Everybody's got a gun.
Everybody's gun. The home team's on the run. Hey
there. Now we're gonna have some fun.
What did your daddy do? Why am I singing too? They took an itty bit. Okay, I'm sorry. I'll stop.
Okay.
All right, we're gonna answer questions now. This is the answering questions music. Okay, I can't focus. These are fun. Oh man, I can't wait for my answers to come up for to find out what people think about my answers.
I was feeling so positive about my last round's answers, but it didn't win me the game.
No, well, you got second place though.
I did okay.
Like, why are you complaining?
I'm not complaining. I've just stated a thing that I feel.
It's true. The rum chata is kicking in. I'm starting to get a little kooky. Mm.
Ass Ninja Lolo. Always good to see Ass Ninja Lolo in digital world.
Digital World, starring Jason Stevens.
A better name for the Washington Monument. America Cock. And Erectional Monument. I imagine when George Washington, did he have anything to do with it being built or did it come after him? I don't even know.
George?
Yeah. No, yes, George Jefferson.
George Jefferson?
Yeah.
I don't think he had anything to do with it.
Oh.
I'm sure it was built after those other presidents became popular.
Erectional Monument was the winner there.
And next is an item not
That's you.
An item not found in Taylor Swift's purse. Taylor Swift. Or a long-term boyfriend.
Ooh.
Hmm. I met Taylor Swift a couple of times.
Over the radio or in reality?
In reality.
Oh my god, you met Taylor Swift?
A few times, yeah.
Holy shit, dude.
Yeah, she's nice, but she was like real, she's like, was real business. You know, really? Like really,
she knows her way around.
10 years ago,
is what Jason is saying.
Yeah, she's really good.
Where's my points? Fuck
you
guys. You
don't get any points for that bullshit.
God damn. It's funny. Okay, next one. A good fake name to use when checking into. She was all about
a
the
good
business.
Fake name to use when checking into a hotel. Hotel adulterer man or. Emery chiropractor.
Oh, come on. I can't choose. Oh, man. Shit. Pastor Joe wants to know if her legs are as fabulous as they look. Did you see her legs?
I didn't really see her legs. I know she was like, the first time I met her, she had just, like, it was on her first album tour. She played a gig for the radio station I worked with.
A good place to hide... Oh, wait, this is you.
Yeah, a good place to hide boogers. In between your gooch or meat locker. Anyway, she came and did a show, and she had to come from... She had to... Like, her family had to... charter a plane to make it to the show, and they got paid way less than she was getting at that time, but they still did the show because she said she would. In between your gooch with the wind.
Jubal Nut got it, a lot of it.
And then the second one of the other times I met her, she had a lot more success by that point.
The perfect name for a second head that sprouts on your shoulder. A tumor or Lil Kim.
So she, but, you know, she was like, she's always been really smart about not letting people get unflattering pictures of her. And she, you know, she makes sure she's good with the fans and all that stuff. And I remember she was wearing pasties so that her nip, she wouldn't nip out. And I was like some guy pointed this, my boss or whatever pointed that out to me. And he was like, hey, she was wearing pasties. That's like.
She was topless and she was wearing pasties.
No, she had a shirt on. But anyway, it's weird. Fun thing to do if you're locked in the mall overnight. Reassemble mannequins or shoplift all the department stores.
I think Taylor Swift probably doesn't know her way around a cock, and that's why she can't keep a boyfriend.
Well, you know, there's more to relationships than... No, no.
That was,
Never mind.
That was, like... tired storyteller Jason.
Yeah, like, yeah. No, she did not remember me. She wouldn't remember.
Yeah, I thought I didn't. I vote? What the hell happened?
Yes, Knack. Why the fuck am I still talking about Taylor Swift? I guarantee that's the most I've talked about her in the last 5 years.
Whose turn? Mine.
Yes.
Why did the mortician cross the road? To get to the other died?
Oh.
Or to scrap the rest of the person of the ground. To scrap the rest of the person of the on the ground.
To scrape the rest of the person off the ground.
To scrape the rest of the person off the ground.
I think they were just trying to type fast.
Yes. That's a long answer.
Yes, that man pointed me at her nipples. That's what happened.
Well... Come on, I spelled mine right.
Double nut.
I don't know how to read, like, secretary type.
What John Goodman's belches smell like? A depressed wife and kids? or fucking a stranger in the ass.
He's lost a lot of weight. Did you see how skinny he is now?
Yeah.
It's weird.
I occasionally get ADR requests for John Goodman, and I can't do it. But if I could, I would say, oh, I haven't been fucking a stranger in the ass as John Goodman. You know, you could say that the depressed wife and kids might be because his belches smell like that.
Hey, man, Grayskull is cleaning up this round. He's going to be the
leader
for sure.
But Man of Doom won.
Oh, shit. So. What the hell?
Yeah.
Nice.
Audience votes on that one.
Here we go. Was this round two?
Yep.
No, this was round one.
Well, it will be round two soon enough. Assy.
Oh.
Aaron in next to last place.
I usually get second to last place. All right, I'm going to focus on my answers this time. I'm not going to say a damn thing.
Well, somebody's got to entertain the folks.
I'm not going to. I want to win.
If you don't know, then you can't be told.
Okay, I focused on my answers. You like that? Good. Great. Thanks. You're welcome. Thank you. I'm talking to myself. Oh, I got a PM. Oh, no. Blake Miller bought me two more shots. Well, fuck it. I'm going to drink them right now, because then why not?
Okay, we got it. Who was more obnoxious, Taylor Swift or Panic at the Disco? Panic at the Disco.
That was my first shot,
yeah.
Like,
of Panic at the Disco. Definitely.
This bottle of rum chata is almost gone.
A funny thing to write down on your form when it asks for your sex.
Oh, that was my second.
Yes, please. Or did you just assume my gender? And who hasn't been caught in that little tangle? Why do you need to know my sex? What does it matter? I don't identify as...
In romance books, they always put, like, he touched her in the sex.
Yeah.
He touched her sex.
He touched her sex. Her sex was moist. Yeah, it doesn't work. So, look at that! All of us voted for Grayskull.
And all the,
but
audience,
the audience voted
for yes,
the other
please.
One. And Yes Please won.
Wow.
That's the first time I've seen that.
That is weird.
Little known fact.
My turn, right?
Yeah, go ahead.
Little known fact, the human body is approximately 80% jizz or cocaine.
Let me tell you about jizz and cocaine.
Randy Newman?
Let me tell you about jizz and cocaine. I'm trying to abstain.
Yep. Aaron Yanda.
Thank you.
Well done, sir.
I need to stop losing. That's my theory.
Everybody get on board the jizz train.
That's right.
That was, I don't know what that was. The worst thing to vomit into when you suddenly need to vomit. The Holocaust Museum or a stash of sex toys. Can you have a bad meatloaf impression? Yeah, let me think about it a second.
It's like you're starting to feel like you're going to vomit, and you like run down the street to the Holocaust Museum like, oh shit, I got to vomit.
Or you're just walking past it is what I was saying. Like,
Jason's all about Hitler tonight.
Well, you walk like you're walking down the street and you're like, oh, and there's a garbage can to your left and a door to your right. Like, that's the worst. Why would you? Right?
The worst thing you could discover in your burrito, an illegal immigrant Or your uncle's angina medication. Your uncle's angina medication. What is angina?
Angina is like a heart condition.
Oh, God.
Uh-huh. Austin Jen, nicely done, sir.
Where's our audience votes? We're only up to 64. Come on, people.
Yeah, they're giving up on.
We used to have 100.
Yeah, well, we don't have 100
anymore. All right, Double Nut cleaned it up.
Yep.
Nice work, Double.
Double.
He quiplashed it.
Yep.
Damn. And next is
three things MacGyver needs to make a bomb. Used condom, gum, tears of children, or jizz, ammonia, and heartache. Well, jeepers. Well, Jiminy Christmas, I don't know.
Only MacGyver knows.
Wow, audience votes are a little thinner than they were.
They're not, they don't know who MacGyver is.
Oh, yes, that's it. I did not vote for Aaron because I think he went to the jizz well once too often.
Well, come on, I told you all my answers were going to be jizz.
Well, I know, but next up, I thought maybe you'd pull out.
The name of a painting Michelangelo was ashamed he created. Michelangelo's penis or the art of the shart? If you want to be an audience voter, look at that little code up on the screen. See that? Go to jackbox.tv and just enter the code and you can vote. It's that easy.
It's very easy. It's so easier than becoming president of the United States.
No, not quite. Zing.
Ah.
All right, Eldna versus Grayskull. It's an even split. Oh, Grayskull gets the audience vote. Good job, Grayskull.
Grayskull.
Grayskull. Yep. You want to pronounce it the Irishman way?
Okay. What you hope the Mars rover finds? A reason for this marriage or a sick-ass carving of a penis? Colby, the reason why Hillary couldn't do it is because she did not cater to the people who vote in the middle of the country and the edges of the country. And she was not able to beat him.
She was a shit-ass candidate.
Yeah.
Shitty-ass.
What we needed was some person who could say things.
And speak. And
speak things.
Without looking hawkish and
right.
Like she was going to murder you.
To like, who, you just don't have a suspicion that she hates you. The most stereotypical country song title. Fucking Bud Light and tractors and shit. Or Alabama Love Issues.
Oh. Hmm.
Fucking Bud Light and tractors and shit. That is a Jason Aldean song right there.
Fucking Bud Light and tractors and shit.
I fucked a goat in my pickup truck. Burr, burr.
That sounds like a song I might write sometime.
Alabama Love Issues in my truck.
Truck nuts.
At the bar.
Yeah.
Fucking Bud Light and tractors and shit.
You know, I was never able to do a very good Bernie Sanders impression. For whatever reason.
Well, good thing you didn't become president then. Thank God, everybody.
I think I probably would have figured it out, but, yeah. That's right, Ben. Nobody gives a shit about the election anymore. It was like a forever ago. Yep.
Damn it. Are you in second place again? You never win, Jason, but you're always in second place.
Always the bridesmaid.
But never the brewery.
Well, you know, this is the third round, so I could win.
All point values are tripled. We're all going to answer it, and then we distribute our 3 points however we please. A punchline for a joke that would make children cry.
Hmm.
Oh, I barely got that one in under the wire.
Oh, wow, there's a timer. Oh, a couple people didn't get their
answers.
People
didn't make the final timer.
And
a punchline for a joke that would make children cry. Trump is the best. No, you can't have my unconditional love. Orange, you glad I didn't say molestation again. You're adopted and your parents never loved you. Giving them a rusty fish hook. And Santa isn't real. Santa isn't real. Punchline. All right. I can't wait to see how this shit goes down.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah. Yeah.
All right, there we go. Jason voted for Trump as the best.
I gave it one vote.
Giving him 6%.
I giving him 6%.
You gave him 6%. Chris F. gets some percentages.
9%.
That one.
That's a 9.
Chris Skull gets...
9%.
9 also.
I got
Jason
a few votes. That's nice.
Gets a bunch
a
of votes.
Bit.
You 11%. Usually land about here. 11-12% yeah. are your favorite.
I mean, not good when it's up against everyone like that. Double
oh,
not voted
Alden
three times.
Fuck
really.
All of us. This meeting is going really well for you, isn't it? Oh, yeah. Oh.
That was, it's a pretty good one because it actually it fits a joke, Aaron. Good
thank
job.
Thank you. You're welcome. Oh my God, I've never gotten that high of points before. The shots are really helping me out here.
Orange, you glad. Aaron.
Come on, will this catapult me into a massive... No, I can't.
Nope.
I get second, though.
Second. I'm in fourth. I'll do it. Double nut. Good job,
God damn Double nut. Double nut. Good work.
All right. I have to go take a piss.
You do that. I will ever entertain everyone with a John
so,
Madden...
I don't know what this has to do.
Talking about
fruit. I don't
know
what I do with that. Just what? Okay.
Oh, yeah. Blake Miller, when he gave me the shots, and I meant to read these. Oh, God. Okay, well, this will be a great thing to do while Jason's out of the room, so I don't have to explain it to him. Two more shots for Aaron. Mwahahaha. Also, let's hear you say Tigger without the bleeps, so we will all know what was really said in Disneyland Adventures, LOL. Well, I just said it once, and I'll say it again, and this is what I always said during that whole video, was Tigger. There's nothing, like, weird or, like, horrible about it. I just said Tigger over and over, and they bleeped it. And they made me seem like a monster. Adam is laughing. Wait, Adam, do that again. Did you hear that? I put my headphones up to the speaker so you could hear his horrible fucking evil laugh in my head, in my ears. Well, here, do it. Are you ready? Okay, and do it. There you go. Did you hear? That's what I have to deal with. That's what I have to deal with. All right, we're going to do one more round before we go to the after party. So get ready to pump those buzzers one last time for Quiplash. How have you guys liked this? I've been really enjoying this. I'm curious what you... I'm Tiggered. Oh, that's good. How have you guys been enjoying Quiplash? I really had a good time. I'd love to play it again. I know a lot of people don't know what it is and are probably like, I'm not going to click on that. I don't know what the fuck that shit is, but like... It's really fun, right? I'm having a really good time. I love you guys.
You gotta wait for me. I had to go pee. There's an emergency potty.
A pee emergency. I had a pre emergency.
So much urine
came out of my
it
pee
was
body.
So wet.
Ugh. Okay, so don't do anything, Jason.
Okay, I'm not doing anything
until I give you a cue. Oh, we'll go ahead and start it, because I gotta get back to the right spot. So, this first one's gonna be a wash, we won't do it. But go ahead and, set it up there, Slacky.
Slacky? What? Me?
Yeah, you do it.
New?
Yeah, new player.
Okay. And then am I doing it?
Could try, I guess. Don't go in before me, or maybe you should, I don't know. Sorry, we're doing it over because Adam wasn't ready, so it's fine, you guys. We're doing it over.
Doing it over? Never mind.
What'd you say, Adam?
What I gotta do? How do I get out of that?
I'll tell them. I will. I'll take care of it. Boink.
Ah, there we go.
All right, we're gonna start a new one. Here we go. Adam, hold on, are you ready?
Hold on. I gotta do the Jackbox website. Hold on.
Okay, Jason, can you get in?
Hold on.
Can you do it? You can do it, Jason. Yeah, Jason did it.
Yay, I did it.
Nice. All right, everybody's in.
I did it.
Here we go. I'm impressed that some of you are able to actually consistently get in.
Yeah.
So anyway, if you want to come to the after party where you can, you're pretty much guaranteed to be able to play with us because everyone's really nice there and they'll let you in. Patreon.com/GameSocietyPimps. $5 a month. If you only want to do it for 1 month, that's up to you. Helps us out a lot, but $5 will get you into this tonight. It's all over at Patreon. It's just, yeah, it's a hangout like this, basically, but it's more personal. Like, we're more there for you. Like, if you want to talk to us about what's happening in your life or something, whatever, man, we're there for you. Like, but we'll talk about really salacious things, too, and things that we won't talk about here in public. It's, like, private. It's really... It's, like, it's, like, 20 people you talk directly to you. It's, like, super exclusive. It's, like, so good. It's, like, so... If I was Trump, I could do this. I could explain it. I gotta answer my questions now. Okay, I just came up with my best answer of the night.
Oh, did it have jizz in it?
It didn't. There is actually not anything related to sex at all. And I'm really curious to see if it gets zero votes. I'm challenging all of you to give me the points.
We've got, what, 79 people in the audience?
Yeah, and if you want to put in that code, go to jackbox.tv and put in the code, and you can actually vote for your favorite answer.
A weird photo to keep in your wallet, a severed head, or Emery nudes. Huh. Huh.
Hmm.
Huh.
Getting the shivers.
About the Emery nudes?
Yeah.
Or you're sick. Okay.
I've seen him close to nude already.
Eh, well, you know, none of us are perfect. But still.
Actually, most of you have seen him, like, you know, in his cheerleader outfit, which is pretty close to nude, so.
You won, Aaron.
Ah, damn, not everybody voted. What the hell happened there? What are you guys doing? Sleep at the wheel? Where's all the fucking votes?
Emmer nudes!
The liquid that would make for the worst salad dressing. Cucumber melon wins automatically because no answer. There was apparently some issues people had with the stuff.
There's Gryffindor, Ravenclaw, Slytherin, and Hufflepuff, but what's the new Hogwarts house few have ever heard of? Jared Fogel or Heine Sniffin?
House Jared Fogel or House Heine Sniffin?
Jared Fogel, the Subway sandwich molester.
He didn't actually molest sandwiches.
No, he didn't. He just raped children.
Right. I don't know if he did that.
Yeah, he kind of did.
Did he?
Well, yeah. Oh, child prostitutes or whatever.
Oh, God, what? Really?
I don't know. It's only my answer. Why would I know about him?
Oh. Well, you got a few points for it.
A couple.
Okay, next one. The three ingredients in the worst smoothie ever. Jizz, banana peels, orange juice, or strawberries, puppies, your mom.
Puppies. Yeah, I don't. Yeah, he had child pornography. That's what he had. But I think he also like went overseas at some point.
Didn't he get killed in prison or something?
No. I think he's like the king of the prison because he's in a prison for molesters. So they're all like, "Oh,
he's
you're
king
the,
of the prison.
You're the
okay.
king."
I hate strawberries, so I had to choose that one.
Yeah.
They are bad in smoothies. Do not like it.
I thought the jizz answer was yours, Aaron.
Nope. Someone's trying to fake you out.
A bad name for a brand of hot sauce. Anus burner or touch a poop.
We're just Game Society now because, well, I mean, we're still Game Society pimps. Okay? We're still Game Society pimps. We're just Game Society on the surface. It's like, until you scratch the surface, you don't know we're Game Society pimps. Does that make sense? It's like when you get one of those chocolate-covered popsicle things. We're like the pimps part is the creamy underneath.
Wow.
I know what I'm saying. Jason, you
dominated.
Anus
Burner won.
But Anus Burner won, even though you dominated.
Yep.
Holy shit.
Still got the winner bonus over there. Next in line, the audience liked that.
Yeah, we can still get you all pussy, no problem. The worst thing to find frozen in an ice cube, Stuart Little, or your mom.
Yeah. That's a good one. That's a really good answer.
Which answer?
Stuart Little.
Oh.
Honestly, I just... When I was in college, we used to play D&D, and there was this guy who was stoned all the time, which was difficult because he's playing D&D and he was always asking like, "Wait a minute, where are we?"
God.
And I used to piss. His name was Jim, and I used to piss him off by just saying like, "Jim, your mom." A bad place to skinny dip in the piranha tank or public pool.
Ooh. I know what the audience is going to choose. They're going to choose public pool. Guarantee it.
Incorrect, Aaron. They did pick the piranha tank.
Gotcha, Addy. Oh, shit. I'm Just Incredible's gonna fuck us all. Something fun to scream when you win in a game of bingo other than bingo. Fuck my life!
Automatic win for fuck my life.
Or no answer. Well, that's not really... You're not gonna win at bingo if you have no answer.
Jokes
so.
Are Lit did not enter any...
God damn
answers.
It. They must have got ejected. Their phone broke or ran out of juice or they ran out of juice or they just decided to go masturbate instead of play this.
Mm-hmm.
It's probable. God damn it, Just Incredible. God damn it. I was going to win.
Round two. Fight. Fart.
Fart.
Round two. Fart.
Round two. Hermione. Oh. Shit. Gotta think of a good one for this, you guys. Talk amongst yourselves. Okay, that's probably not a winner, but at least get a couple votes for it, I bet. It's funny, like, how I can come up with an answer now, and I kind of, like, can guess how many votes it will get. Sort of. Okay, so, while Jason's finishing filling out his answers, I'm going to tell you guys about where you can guaranteed play with us tonight. We're going to play this game again. patreon.com/gamesocietypimps. You can give us $5 once if you want, or however many months in a row you want to do it, but 1 month, you'll get 1 month for $5, and you'll be able to play with us tonight.
Jokes are lit. You suck.
Fucking A, man. Emery's pubes just won because jokes are lit, but isn't playing. Shit. Okay, next one. A bad substitute. It's a live Q&A. We'll talk to you. We can answer whatever questions you want. All access. You guaranteed access to us.
A bad substitute for a toothbrush. Your best friend's penis. Hashtag free toothbrush. Toothpaste. Free toothpaste. Or log. I messed up the hashtag.
Jason, ruining answers everywhere.
Yep. Oh!
That's good because... Oh, son of a bitch! Yeah, the
audience,
seriously?
Audience didn't appreciate your Ren and Stimpy reference.
I'm Just Incredible is apparently much funnier than me. I should just give up. The worst thing to try to sell door-to-door, Roadhouse 2 screenplay, or homelessness.
Yes, Batman. You want to live in my house? Fart.
Bane, you sound so tired.
I've been up all day. Turning
into a vampire?
I'm trying not to become a vampire.
Yeah, somebody said the Roadhouse 2 was mine, and they were right. So.
And you didn't get the audience vote either.
No.
Well, you and I are... No one likes us.
Nope.
No one likes us.
What would make baseball more entertaining to watch? Humongous nipple or rabid squirrels?
Humongous nipple, of course, a Fallout 4 reference.
Yeah.
This is last call. Adam wants me to let you know this is last call if you want any sort of shout-outs or anything, because we're going to go to the after party after this round is over.
Flamin' French Fry Productions is finagling to try to get a Polaroid of Emery naked every month, but they don't know that Polaroids don't exist.
Oh, they do. If you send me a Polaroid camera, I'll get you one. Okay. Guarantee it.
Of him naked every month.
Every month.
For $5 a month.
I can do that. Yep, $5 a month is worth it. Do it.
Wow.
Humongous took it away.
Yep, Humongous Nipple Man.
A peculiar thing to see in a Help Wanted ad would be Help Wanted blank. Help Wanted, wait, never mind. Or Help Wanted Poster Maker. See, now it'd be weird because they put Help Wanted twice.
Thank you, Jacob. Brick-a-brack Theater was kind of what started everything with the voice stuff, so.
Yeah, that was was that one of the first times you did your Morgan Freeman impression, like, anywhere?
I think so, yeah.
Holy shit.
Yeah, you and Matt, you were like, you should do this, and I was like, I don't know, guys, I'm not really good at that.
We forced him to do Morgan Freeman, and now look where he is.
Forced me to have a career, thank you.
Now he's sitting here with me, making poop jokes.
I'm also making dick jokes.
Oh yeah, dick jokes too. Plasto Joe dominates. And next,
the name of a new U.S. state you would never visit. Stabifornia or jokes are lit sucks.
It's not probably not their fault. They
no,
probably died.
Probably not. They may have died. They may have had a stroke and a heart attack and died.
Probably both of them.
Cancer.
What kittens would say if they could talk? Fabio, my love, or fuck the police. I know what kittens would say.
Yeah. I think we all do. I'm bracing myself for zero votes.
Did you answer Fabio, my love?
Yes.
Oh, shit.
The clock was ticking. I had to come up with something. I had to do it, yeah. Fuck the police, shit. Man.
Can't Fabio. Here
yeah.
You go. You got one vote and 17 nice. Audience votes. That's nice.
That's a nice. It's
nice.
Nice
for you.
That's really nice. It's nice.
It's really good.
It's really nice. When Adrian died, I don't know what happened. Next up,
the real reason the dinosaurs died.
Oh, yeah.
Masturbation or onwiosauruses? I feel bad now for T-Rex. With those little hands, he can't get down there. Just gotta rub it on a stump, I guess. Flamin' French Fry Productions says, where can I send my camera? They really want that. That Emery nude photo.
Send it. Yeah, send it to adamkorolik.com. Okay. What's going to happen here?
Something.
Oh, my God.
You're in the lead.
Oh, my God.
You're winning.
Oh, Aaron, you can do this. I know you can do this. I can so do this.
This is the last round, Aaron. You better not suck or you're going
to
lose.
I'm going to have to stop thinking and talking.
Stop stinking and talking, Aaron.
I'm not going to stink at all.
A name for a really bad Broadway musical.
Oh, man. So many options. I thought of a really terrible one, but I can't answer it. Oh god, I'm running out of time. I didn't have time to put my whole answer in, but I tried.
Fat fucks.
A name for a really bad Broadway musical. Fat fucks. Sir Mix-a-Lot the musical. Mel Gibson's The Passion. Auschwitz. Once Upon a Mike Pence. Oh man.
Where is Emery Thickass at? That's a good question.
He's editing
Dana.
Skyrim for Pimps right now as we speak. We wouldn't allow him to do this because he's got to get it done.
He's got to get it done. He's got to get it done with his thick ass.
We're recording voiceover tomorrow. He's got to get all the footage recorded tonight.
Such so a thick ass.
We can do that.
So thick.
He does have a
story. So thick.
It's like a side of bacon except 70 times larger.
70 bacons.
All right, Mel Gibson's The Passion gets 14%. Jason, Sir Mix-a-Lot the Musical, doing quite well for himself. 18%, nice, a new best for Jason Stevens. Fat fucks from Aaron.
Yep, you got all my votes there. Man. You got all my votes.
Got 20%. That might be enough. It just depends on what Crample Nubbets answered and if he's going to catch up.
That's a big one.
That is a big one. Oh, shit. How about
JW
Young's too far behind?
They love their Holocaust jokes, folks. They love them.
26%?
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
It would be a very bad Broadway musical.
I don't think that's enough to beat me. I think I might have won. This is the best day of my life if I won.
You won!
Yes!
By almost 1,000 points,
my
Aaron.
My first one, just for answering fat fucks.
Yeah.
Emery Nudes, all my answers, they're so good, you guys. I trumped this round.
Yes, so good. You said your answers were going to be so good, and they were very great. They were very, very great.
Thank you, Donald.
You're very welcome. You know, I didn't think I was going to like Adam or Emery or Aaron when I met them all, but I did.
What do you like most about us?
I think I like because you have beards. I can't grow a beard. I'm not allowed to grow a beard. Presidents can't do it.
Presidents can't grow beards?
Not anymore. Because people think you're a communist if you have a beard.
Who was the last president to have a beard?
Probably like a Rutherford B. Hayes or something. Hold on, let me juggle it. Let me get the juggle. Hold on a second.
All right, well, Trump does that, I'd like to thank everybody.
Who is the last president to have a beard?
William Howard Taft.
William Howard Taft.
From US politics
had a beard. He's the fattest president.
The last president to wear any facial hair was William Howard Taft.
He's the fattest fuck.
He was the star of the musical Fat Fucks.
He got stuck in the bathtub in the White House. I still have the bathtub.
The electric bathtub?
I took a shit in it yesterday.
Is it still electric?
No.
Ah, that's too bad. All right, everybody. Well, we're going to send you your Emery nudes over on Patreon. If you're over there, we're going to immediately send you some Emery nudes. Join us for the after party. Patreon.com/GameSocietyPimps. Thanks to everybody who donated and watched and commented and voted and answered and listened and...
Yeah, that's a good... Yep.
That's the end. That'll be the end. Good night.